Shortly before the pandemic, our brief but spectacular team traveled to Georgia, where they spoke with two high school seniors, Audrey McNeal and Shaylon Walker, about race and about being underestimated.
I recently got a full ride to a very prestigious university, and I went back to go visit my elementary school teachers. And so there's this one teacher, she runs into me in the hall, and the other teacher I was walking with, she starts bragging on me, and she's like, yeah, Shaylon here has got a full ride to Boston University. And the other teacher stops, and she goes, so what is it? And I was like, what is what? She's like, what's your sport? Excuse me. I got an academic and leadership scholarship. I don't play a sport.
2 years ago, I was sitting in my graphics and design class, and there was an anonymous death threat using the N-word. There was no investigation whatsoever. Black people, we internalize these things. You know, does my life really matter to my school or my community or my county who doesn't even want to look into these threats?
When you even look at how teachers interact with students of color versus white students, when a teacher comes up to you and you respond in a manner that might not be cheerful or might not be what they want to hear, it's automatically, oh, you have an attitude. And I've experienced this. I'm not even that type of person. Like, if you know me, I don't even have that type of attitude. And so when I get that, it's kind of like, whoa. But then each time, it kind of becomes less and less like a whoa because it is a pattern. It's so familiar. Oh, if I'm not smiling, oh, I'm gonna be taken as an angry black woman. We have parents come forward, we have actual students come forward, we have picture evidence, we have recordings, we have everything saying, hey, we have a problem here. But the county comes back to us and they're like, no, we've had training on that. No, that's not happening. You're not gonna make me think I'm crazy because I know what I feel and I know what I see every day.
There's this quote by Benjamin Franklin that says that justice will not be served until those who are unaffected are just as outraged as those who are. So sometimes when I'm the only black person in a classroom that has to speak on issues that are particularly challenging or things that make me or other people feel uncomfortable, it keeps me going because I know that these conversations are important and it pushes me to challenge not only myself but my peers to talk about these things.
The first thing you have to do is acknowledge the problem. Even if it may not be you or your people group, you have to take a step back and look in and see that something is wrong. Once you've learned about the issue, you're gonna take that knowledge and enlighten others. You're gonna open their eyes to something that may not even be apparent to them. And so once you've done all those three things, you yourself have created a vessel for change. You are a catalyst that will lead to a greater future for those coming after us.
My family has lived in Georgia for generations. We have directly been affected by the institution of slavery. And so I see a people, especially in my family, that is strong and people who want to fight for change and to keep moving forward. I use that to inspire myself to keep creating change because it can be done. My name is Audrey McNeal.
My name is Shaylon Walker.
And this is my brief but spectacular take
on acknowledging that there's a problem.
Two strong young women.